Namaskaram. Welcome to day 4 of the Natyakala conference themed on Shringaram. Today we have a packed day of some extremely exciting sessions, very diverse, colorful, and all the sessions are Natya oriented. We will be starting with a combined presentation of Odissi and Bharatanatyam on Radha and the Gita Govindam. And then we move on to Mohiniyattam and how it treats Shringaram. And then we move on again to Atimoham, a dialogue on the portrayal of the sacred and sensual in metaphor and movement, and end with a performative paper on gender fluidity in the Vaishnava tradition. All varied, intriguing, and highly informative. Ladies and gentlemen, don't go away and stay through them all. His mind afflicted by the wounds inflicted by Cupid's arrows, he wandered here and there in search of his Radhika. Overcome by remorse, he came to a bower by the banks of the Yamuna and there started to lament. I'm sure this audience needs no introduction to the Gita Govindam. Krishna is realized in love, and in his love, he breaks all fetters, and the loved one unites with him in absolute oneness. In a sense, the Gita Govinda is a broad metaphor which reveals through romantic love the bliss of spiritual union of the human soul with the divine. Initially, Krishna loves his favored one, Radha. Later, he loves other maidens. Radha, the favored one, separated from him, is annoyed for his infidelity, but her longing to unite with him is endless. Krishna realizes this, and filled with repentance, he meets her and the two unite in perpetuity. Along with its deeper philosophical meaning, the Gita Govindam is also endowed with a very high level of lyricism and sensuality. It forms an important part of many of our classical dance repertoires, naturally, due to its highly emotive content. One has also read that Radha's moods throughout the Gita Govindam reflect at least 7 of the 8 Ashtanayika states. So today we have 2 eminent artists, Srimati Sharmila Biswas and Srimati Vidya Subramanian, who are going to invoke Radha in the context of the Gita Govindam. Srimati Sharmila Biswas is one of the leading dancers and choreographers who has made a considerable contribution to the development and promotion of Odissi dance and music in the past 2 decades. One of the prominent disciples of Guru Kelucharan Mahapatraji, noted for the originality of her composition, technique and stage design, her choreography is strongly based on research. Srimati Vidya Subramanyam is an eminent Bharatanatyam artist, trained under gurus Swami Malai Shri S.K. Rajaratnam and Srimati Kalanidhi Narayanan. In her charismatic creativity, one witnesses a strong belief in the validity of choreographic structure combined with openness to new influences. A sought-after artist to perform and teach, she has an MA in Theatre Arts from the San Jose State University. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Srimati Sharmila Biswas and Srimati Vidya Subramanyam, who are going to take us through invoking Radha through the Gita Govindam. Thank you.
Namaskar. In Odissi, our understanding of Radha Bhava begins with Gita Govinda, Jayadev's Radha. This Radha and her Shringar, I can best explain through the Ashtapadi Sakhihe Keshi Mathanamudaram. It is through this Ashtapadi that I finally could touch that Radha, Sada Prafulla Chitta, Radha. Radha, who is completely unself-conscious, completely unaware of her Radha status. I begin, Sakhihe Keshi Mathanam Udaram. Was it just an accident that I, Radha, saw Krishna playing with a bunch of girls? I don't know what came over me. I think I was distracted. I kept roaming in the forest as if in a trance. I came home. I sat in the corner of my room, alone. It was evening. The fact is, that's the only time women like us get for ourselves, to get ready for puja and all the endless household work which awaits us. But that evening was different. I kept tying my hair, but my same fingers kept untying. Freedom. Freedom. A bee comes. Who are you? Are you a friend of Krishna? Have you come to tempt me? I give in. I close all the windows in the room. I sit in that little corner and make a world there. I pick up my mirror. In that mirror, I see reflection, a forest. I get into the forest.
Nibhuta Nikunja Gruhang Gatayanishi. Rahasiniliya vasantam chakita vilokita sakala disha rati rabhasa rasena hasantam.
When I go into the forest at night, Krishna, searching for you, you hide inside my mirror, laughing at me.
Ramaya maya saha madana manuratha bhavitaya savikaram.
You lose yourself at just the thought of us together. Who are you?
Prathama samagama lajjitaya patu chatu shatair anukulam mrudu madhura smita bhashitaya shithilikruta jaghana dukulam.
When I face you, you entice me with your words. I smile, I begin to reply. And then I find that you have loosened my skirt. Why, Krishna? You know my body flowers only for you, and the petals drop at your feet for you.
Kishalaya shayana niveshitaya chiramurasi mamaiva shayanam kruta parirambhana chumbanaya parirabhya krutadharapanam.
We lie on a bed of leaves for an eternity. You respond to my tentative kisses. You drink the nectar from my lips, don't you?
Kokila kalarava pujitaya jita manasija tantra vicharam shlatha kusumakula kuntalaya nakhalikhita ghanastana bharam.
In ecstasy, I utter sweet sounds, bird songs rising from my throat. You make love to me, surpassing all the shastras of Kamdev. Flowers fall from my disheveled hair. You trace patterns on my breast with your nails. No, not patterns. It's your divine tilak you paint. Are you that force, marking me as your own.
Charana ranita mani nupuraya paripurita surata vitanam mukhara vishunkhala mekhalaya sakachagraha chumbanadanam.
The rhythm of our bodies is matched by the rhythm of my anklets. Even my waistband resounds. You draw me by my hair and kiss the life away from me. Who are you who consumes me? Keshi Mathana Mudaram. The beautiful wild horse with flying unrestrained hair. You had swept her away, vanquished her. You brought her salvation. Keshi Mathanam Udaram. That evening, when I was returning home.
Sakhi he, Keshi Mathanam Udaram. Keshi Mathanam Udaram.
Madhava.
Keshi Mathanam Udaram.
Keshava.
Keshi Mathanam Udaram.
Krishna.
Keshi Mathanam
Keshava
Udaram.
Hari Madhava.
Keshi Mathanam
Krishna
Udaram.
Krishna.
Keshi Mathanam
Hari
Udaram.
Udaram.
Tana din 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 Tanadim Tara dim 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 dir na 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 na. Tara dim 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 dir na 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 na. Tara dim 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 dir na 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 na. Tara dim. Tara tara dere na na dere na dere na tara dim 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 dere na 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 tara dim 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 dere na 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 tara dim 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 dere Unarapi manobhavam Unarapi manobhavam प्रथम समागम लज्जितया परु चाटुशतैरनुकूलम् मृदु मधुरस्मित भाषितया शिथिलीकृत जघनदुकूलम् केशी मथन
मुखरविशृङ्खलमेखलया
ಸಕಚಗ್ರಹ ಚುಂಬನ ದಾನಂ ಸಕಚಗ್ರಹ ಚುಂಬನ ದಾನಂ ಸಕಚಗ್ರಹ ಚುಂಬನ ದಾನಂ
At the outset, let me thank Sri Nidhi, the Natikala Conference, and Sri Krishna Gana Sabha for this wonderful opportunity to invoke Radha, my favorite heroine today. Krishna Gana Sabha is where I grew up. I've danced many times and been in the audience many times and been part of the Natikala Conference, both from the audience as well as on stage. So this is very special for me. I'm going to dance first, and then I'll do a little bit of talking afterwards. Today, with me is Murali Parthasarathy. I decided to use just vocal, thought voice and dance alone would be beautiful for Radha. So I'll show an example of Vipralamba and an example of Sambhoga, and then talk to you about my process. Thank you.
ಕಜಲಮಲಿನ ವಿಲೋಚನ ಚುಂಬನ ವಿರಚಿತ ನೀಲಿಮರೂಪಂ ಕಜಲಮಲಿನ ವಿಲೋಚನ ಚುಂಬನ ವಿರಚಿತ ನೀಲಿಮರೂಪಂ ದಶನ ವಸನಂ ಅರುಣೋ ತವ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ತನೋತಿ ತನೋರನುರೂಪ ದಶನ ವಸನೋ ಮರುಣೋ ತವ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ತನೋತಿ ತನೋರನುರೂಪ ಯಾಹಿ ಮಾಧವ ಯಾಹಿ ಕೇಶವ ಮಾವದ ಕೈತವ ವಾದಂ ಯಾಹಿ ಮಾಧವ ಯಾಹಿ ಕೇಶವ ಮಾವದ ಕೈತವ ವಾದಂ ಯಾಹಿ
ಮನೋಭವ ಮಂಗಲ ಕ
sahodare mrigamada patrakam atra manu
Gosh, I thought it would be easier to dance first and then talk. Srinidhi has just told me I have about 4 minutes. Okay, I'll try to keep this short. I did my master's thesis. I just want to say this debate between bhakti and shringaram to me is irrelevant because I feel there is so much reciprocity between the two, so much interaction, so much intermingling, and it's so difficult to pinpoint those fine differences that call it bhakti shringaram or shringara bhakti. I feel they coexist. And one can agree that shringaram is a gift to Indian classical dance forms. And who better than Radha, the most erotic of humans, to portray this shringaram? Jayadeva has given us this strong, sensuous, self-aware heroine as dancers to work with. And it's always a very freeing experience for me personally to dance Radha. And I thought I'll go through the process that I experience a little bit. Of course, it goes without saying, we start with lyrics, lyrics, lyrics. I know many dancers have heard this, but it warrants repeating. Lyrics, when I say, when you take an Ashtapadi, there are 8 stanzas, and the dancer, the student, I feel, must study all 8. Even if you're going to present just 1 or 2 in a performance, all 8 have to be studied so you understand the entire context from beginning to end. And not only that, the placement of the Ashtapadi in in the Gita Govindam, Kuru Yadu is the 24th and last Ashtapadi. It would be very different from Sakihe, which is the 6th Ashtapadi. So the Sambhugam in the 2 is handled very differently according to the placement in the Gita Govindam as well. Of course, the Ragam and the musical journey leads you through the path of combined, just like Shringaram and Bhakti, they coexist. And trying to understand the character as Jayadeva intended and infusing my own emotional history into this process. To dance Radha, I feel one needs to have a strong sense of self, a strong sense of self-awareness and understanding of yourself, because if you don't, then how can you dance a strong heroine like her? And not only self, but also lack of self-consciousness. And because I feel self-consciousness is a sign of ego. With that ego comes the me, I am dancing Radha. Where is the I in this? So why the self-consciousness? One also needs, these are in no particular order, but one also needs an intuitive sensitivity. By this I mean observation of the world around us, observation of human behavior, of how people interact, how people talk, how people walk, smile. There are so many things around us that offer inspiration that we can take from. Then allowing Radha to permeate me, the dancer, and also allowing myself to enter her character. Who she is in that composition enters my being, and who I am colors her. So the character that you see when I perform is a combination of her and me. So this sort of humanizes her for me, and not, you know, without putting her on a pedestal, deifying her and putting her on a pedestal. And the same, I feel, goes for Krishna. So this relationship between them is so special that if we deify them, it becomes harder to dance it. Then, of course, there's the conversation going on in the head. It is constant. It is Mami's training. The external conversation is between Krishna and Radha. And this feeling that he is listening only to me, because you see, he loves only me. at least for the duration of the Ashtapadi. And then the conversation between Radha and me. So why does that conversation need to happen? Because if it is just her, what happens is there's a withdrawal, there's a sense of separateness. She becomes this, again, put on a pedestal heroine. And if I'm not there, that's what happens. But if, on the other hand, it is just me, well, that'll be a crazy Radha, so we don't want that. Lastly, I feel one needs courage. Courage to bring her to life every time. I won't say much more about this. But just a couple of lines about the differences in delineating Vipralambha and Shringara. We have the icy, in-control Nayika in Yahi Madhava. Her ego and pride are hurt. She knows that he belongs to everyone. This universality of Krishna is in the back of her head. Yet, the woman in her, the Vidya in her, is this hurt woman who's been wronged. So she lashes out. So it's again finding that balance, that combination between her presence and mine. Then Kuru Yadu is Sambhoga. She's again bold, sensuous, in command, yet very demanding. There's no coyness in her. Does dancing her need me to be all of those? Yes and no. Everyone has, all of us have experiences that we can borrow from life, and finding the common threads as an actor on stage is to tap into those sources, I feel, when I portray her. So Sambhoga or Vipralambha, the awareness of the gaze, the spectator's gaze, is important, but not the self-consciousness that may arise from that gaze. So one needs to do away with that. And if portrayed with sensitivity and understanding, from an open audience, there's equal understanding and sensitivity I've felt, even to the most uninitiated of audiences. Wherever I presented it, Europe or anywhere, it speaks. I'd like to end with a quote. In art, as in love, instinct is enough. In the art of presenting Shringaram, I feel the performer and the spectator must listen to instinct and must follow its music. Thank you.
Now both Sharmila and Vidya would like to take any questions, if there are any. Just two, please, because we have four sessions today. Yes, please. Mic to the last. There's someone there with a question. Yeah, just go ahead.
A much scrutinized character. How do you go about achieving that lack of self-consciousness?